transcribed.
From Hollywood, we present the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show. Brought to you by Chesterfield. Sound off for Chesterfield. Get something new, something no other cigarette has. Chesterfield mildness plus no unpleasant aftertaste. By Anacin for fast relief from pain of headache, neuritis, and neuralgia. By Dentine, the gum with breathtaking flavor. And by Beeman's Pepsin, the gum that's great to chew and good for your digestion, too. And now it gives me great pleasure to introduce our master of ceremonies, Dean Martin.
Thank you very much. Well, the calendar says that another Friday has rolled around, which means another 30 minutes of doing or dying for dear old Chesterfields, Anacin and Dentine. However, things are going to be a little different tonight. You see, we've been joined by another very nice sponsor who asked us to do an extra 15 minutes. So tonight we'll be around for 45. I know that peace will be shattered when my partner Jerry Lewis, the Velvet Foghorn, arrives. So, while all is quiet, I'd like to try a little Bella Bimba.
Ma come balla bella bimba, bella bimba, bella bimba. Ma come balla bella bimba, bella bimba, bella bimba.
My bella, bella, bella bimba, bella bimba, bella bimba. My bella, bella, bella bimba, bella bimba, bella bimba. Bella bimba.
Always sing, bells always ring, whether it's summer or winter or spring. Be like the birds, just add the words, sing this happy song. Ma come balla bella bimba, bella bimba, bella bimba. Come balla bella bimba, bella bimba, bella bimba. Look everywhere, love's in the air. Dance through the life with the devil may care. Look in your heart, then you will start to sing this happy song. Come balla bella bimba, bella bimba, bella bimba. Ma come balla bella bimba, bella bimba, bella bimba.
My bella, 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 bimba, bella, bimba, bella, bimba.
Ma come balla, bella, bimba, bella, bimba, bella, bimba. Ma come balla, bella, bimba, bella, bimba.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it becomes my pleasure. Jerry Lewis, how many times must I tell her you're not supposed to come out here until you're introduced?
What introduced? I'm Jerry, you're Dean. How do you do? Pleased to meet you. Let's get on with the show.
Now, look, Jerry, forget it. Forget the introduction. Now, tell me, have you finished my laundry yet?
Well, I finished your laundry. Listen here, Dean Martin, I know what you're trying to do. You're trying to make everybody think that just because I'm younger and I'm an idiot, I do all your laundry. You want people should think I take care of your shirts and I wash and starch and dry and iron them. But it won't work. See, I'm wiser, buddy. I'm wiser. And another thing.
What?
The lipstick mark on your blue shirt doesn't rub out.
Now, listen, Jerry, I'm getting mighty tired of your complaining. What makes you act like such a big shot?
Listen, Alfred.
Alfred?
I read in one of them movie magazines that I'm a big picture star. Just like Oscar March.
Oscar March? Oscar, I never heard of him.
Well, that shows how much you know. Oscar March is a star, Death of a Salesman. Why, he may even win a Frederick this year.
Well, You know something, Jer? You're going to drive me to the bug house.
Oh, no, you don't, Dean Martin. I'll stand still for doing the laundry, but I'm not going to be your chauffeur.
Jerry, driving someone to the bug house is just a figure of speech.
Oh, well, that's different. Will you pay for the gas?
Look, now, let's stop arguing, huh? Nobody wins anyway. It's like an immovable object that meets an
irresistible, I notice.
An immovable object that meets an irresistible force.
I was right.
Mm-hmm.
Dean.
What?
I'm irresistible.
All right, Jer. I give up. You win. Tell me, who's our first guest tonight?
Gosh, Dean, we don't have a first guest, but I have an idea that I think we will find Peachy, Ginger, Dandy, Snappy, and King.
You're a good boy.
Why don't we do one of those tender dramatic scenes, you know, where you sing one part and I talk the other part?
Well, all righty, ladies and gentlemen, Jerry and I give you our impression of a man whose girlfriend has just run out on him. He's trying to forget her, but everything he touches recalls another memory. And away we go.
A cigarette that bears a lipstick's traces.
Why does that man insist upon wearing makeup?
An airline ticket to romantic places.
Romantic places. We took one lousy flight from Idlewood to Burbank. Even then we were grounded 6 times because of dust.
And still my heart has wings.
What happened to the mimer?
These foolish things remind me of you.
We had so much to make us happy. You love me despite my old clothes, and I love you despite your old nose.
A tinkling piano in the next apartment.
I haven't slept a wink in 3 days.
Those stumbling words that told you what my heart meant.
What stumbling words? You slapped my back, I bite.
A fairground's painted swing. These foolish things remind me of you.
Foolish things, my foot, they're ridiculous. I was saying to Selma just the other day. Selma, I said, no, listen to this. Selma, I said, you have no idea. He carries on about the least little thing. My lipstick traces, my airline tickets, my painted swings. To help me, I'll go mad from that man.
You came. You saw. You conquered me.
Well, I did beat you 2 falls out of 3.
When you did that to me, I knew somehow it had to be.
Like I told Selma, this thing is just too big for the both of us.
The winds of March that make my heart a dancer.
The winds of March, indeed. Why, that poor Arthur Murray worked his feet to the bone.
The telephone rings, but who's to answer? Oh, how the ghost of you cling.
You can't forget me, Bobby.
These foolish things
remind me of you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And now we turn from foolish things to pleasant ones as we all sound off for Chesterfield. I'm the straight man, you're the wit. Go ahead and do your bit.
I can't think of a single joke, but I'll tell you what, you ought to smoke Chesterfield.
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 Milder, 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 milder Chesterfield. That's right. We've played all over the USA, from Walla Walla to Buzzards Bay.
From Battle Creek to Old Mobile, the folks are changing to Chesterfield. Sound off.
For Chesterfield.
Sound off.
For Chesterfield.
Tie a pack of Chesterfields. Do it.
Today.
It's a fact, ladies and gentlemen, all over America, more and more smokers are sounding off for Chesterfield. Getting Chesterfield Mildness Plus, no unpleasant aftertaste. Smoking pleasure all the way. How about you? Enjoy your smoking. Change to Chesterfield's today. Well, folks, comes time to hit a high spot in the evening's festivities with the introduction of our guest of the evening. And I might add that I can't think of an introduction that would give me greater pleasure. Ladies and gentlemen, here he is, Frank Sinatra.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Dino. Where's the idiot?
Well, I wish you wouldn't call him that. After all, the kid is my partner, and we've worked together for years, and, well, I'd just rather you wouldn't.
Well, I'm sorry, Dean. I didn't realize, you know.
I don't mean to be a square, but that's the way I feel.
All right, Dean, I promise not to say it again.
Good. Now, before the idiot louses us up, how about a song?
For my pleasure, Dean.
How glad the many millions of Annabelles and Lillians would be to capture me. But you had such persistence, you wore down my resistance. I fell, and it was swell. I'm your big and brave and handsome Romeo. How I won you, I shall never, never know. It's not that I'm attractive, but oh, my heart grew active when you came into view. I've got a crush on you, sweetie pie. All the day and night time, hear me sigh. I never had the least notion that I could fall with so much emotion. Could you coo and could you care for a cunning cottage that we both could share? The whole world will pardon my mush, but I have got a crush, my baby, on you.
That was great, really great. And now, if you'll stand by, we'll find out what Jimmy Wallington has a crush on.
Well, thank you, Dean. Ladies and gentlemen, if you would like to know a quick, easy way to ease pain of a headache, neuritis, or neuralgia, then by all means try Anacin. Your own dentist or physician may at one time or another have handed you an envelope containing Anacin tablets. Then you already know how incredibly fast and effectively Anacin brings relief. Anacin is like a doctor's prescription. That is, Anacin contains not just one, but a combination of medically proven active ingredients. For your own sake, try Anacin. Anacin is sold to you on this guarantee. If the first few tablets do not give you all the relief you want as fast as you want it, you may return the unused portion and your money will be refunded. You can get Anacin tablets at any drug counter. Anacin comes in handy boxes of 12 and 30 tablets, and economical family-sized bottles of 50 and 100.
Hey, Dean, is your voice changing? I heard your song and... All right, buddy, the hospital is two blocks away.
Now, easy, Jed. If this boy doesn't need the hospital...
You're right, Dean. Hey, buddy, it's four blocks to Forest Lawn.
Hey, Dean, I don't know who this guy is, but I like him. This kid makes me look good, you know.
Frankie, he's my partner, Jerry Lewis. Go over and introduce yourself to him.
Well, all right. You sure he won't bite? Jerry, I'd like to introduce myself.
Let Dean do it, kid. You better lie down.
Now, listen, apehead. I'm Frank Sinatra.
You mean you're Frank Sinatra, the singer on radio and television and picture star?
That's right.
Hey, is it true that you stand in for carrots when they photograph salads?
Well,
when mosquitoes bite you, do they get anything more than practice?
Well, gosh, I don't know.
Hey, now, tell the truth. Can you touch your hands over your head without being threaded?
Hey, now, just a minute. How long do you think I have to stand here for these insults?
Just as long as we get laughs, Frank.
Now, Jerry, this is no way to act towards Frank Sinatra.
Yeah, well... yeah, well, what makes you think he's Frank Sinatra anyway? If he was Sinatra, he certainly wouldn't be here with us.
No, where would I be?
Home with Ava.
You know, for an idiot, this kid makes a lot of sense.
I was just kidding, Frankie. We're really very glad you could come tonight, honest. We think we're real lucky to have you as a guest. Yes, sirree. We sure are fortunate to have you as our guest. And I mean it, too. Hey, Dean, Como couldn't come?
Can't you show a little more respect? After all, Frank is one of our most popular singers.
What did you say?
I said Frank is one of our most popular singers.
What did you say?
What's the matter with you? Can't you hear?
Oh, sure. I just like the way you turn green when you say it. Don't be jealous, Bobby.
Dino doesn't have to be jealous. He's got a fine voice.
You're a good boy, Frank.
As a matter of fact, Dean, you sound a little like Crosby.
Oh, I haven't been too well.
Been sick.
No, but you really sing real good too, Frank. I just bought a whole bunch of your records. 82 records for 39 cents. Yeah, they forgot to put the hole in the middle.
You know, one good clop, I could put this kid away.
I didn't know you were that tough, Frank.
Didn't you know I used to be a boxer?
Yeah, and I used to be a cocker spaniel.
Don't mess with me, kid. Where I was raised, you had to be tough.
Same with me. I had to fight all the time.
Me too. All the time. It was nothing but fists, fists, fists.
Really?
Sure, I was 12 years old before I knew I had fingers.
Ah, those childhood memories. You know, I'll never forget them.
Yeah, I remember when I first learned to tie my shoelaces. Seems like only yesterday.
What yesterday? It was this morning.
Hey, you know, fellas, I wonder what it would have been like if the three of us had grown up together. I mean, all part of the same gang in the same neighborhood.
Well, let's roll up our pants legs and find out.
Ladies and gentlemen, although most of us would like to, it's impossible for us to return to those carefree days of our childhood. Tonight, however, through the magic of radio, Dean Martin, Jerry Lewis, and Frank Sinatra shall realize this ambition. And so, let's turn back the clock.
My name is Dino. Me and my pal Muscles are the toughest kids on this block.
My name is Muscles. And whoever gave me that name ought to have his head examined.
My name is Jerome. I have my head examined all the time. I'm brand new in this neighborhood. Boy, wait till these fellas see what a load of laughs I am. No kidding. I'm a ton of fun. Ha, ha, ha. Oh, I will speak to them. Hello, fellows.
Shut up.
Goodbye, fellow.
Wait a second. You gotta go home now.
Yeah, I'm a babysitter. I sit on my baby brother.
You sit with the baby, not on him.
So how come they call him Flat Top?
By the way, kid, how did you get that cauliflower ear?
I got it from beer.
You got that ear from drinking beer?
No, Dad uses it to open the bottle.
Let's go, Dino. We only play with the tough guys.
Well, I'm tough. You should have seen me this morning. I kicked Brownie right in the stomach.
Yeah, who's Brownie?
My teddy bear.
I tell you, this kid's a sissy.
What makes you think he's a sissy?
He's wearing underwear.
I'll handle them muscles. Look, Junior, didn't your mother ever tell you the facts of life?
Oh, but I was eavesdropping when she told him to Dad.
Ah, then you do know what girls are.
Sure, I seen them at parties. They're the ones that dance backwards.
What are you talking about? You're ugly. Girls wouldn't go for you anyway.
Yeah, well, I'd like to know what kind of girls would ever go for you.
You'd be surprised.
Surprised? I'm flabbergasted.
Hey, that's funny. You're a comedian.
No, you're a comedian.
You want to bet?
You know what I want to be?
Ah.
When I grow up, I want to be a sailor.
Yeah? What would you do? What would you do if somebody fell overboard?
I taught him a lifesaver.
And what if you didn't have a lifesaver?
I'd throw him a Hershey bar.
You can keep all that sailor stuff. I'm going to be a singer.
You want to bet?
Hey, Dean, what do you say we go down to the corner, huh?
Yeah, I want to buy an ice cream cone. See, I got a dime.
I got an idea. Let's go eeny, meeny, miny, mo. And we'll see who gets the cone.
Hey, that's a good idea. I like that.
With my dime, why not?
Okay, now here goes. Eeny, meeny, miny. Well, I get the cone.
What happened to Mo?
There ain't no Mo. Well, here's the ice cream.
Go ahead, Dino. You can take the first lick.
Hey, fellows, I say, that's my cone. No, fellas, don't lick it. No, I don't care if you hold it, but don't lick it. I mean, you boys are my friends and everything, but don't lick it.
Okay, you win. It don't pay to argue over a cone anyway.
Yeah, let's be friends from now on.
Sure, when we grow up, we can all look back at the time we were kids and we can say...
So late. We loved all those childish games.
Spinning the bottle and kissing games.
I was so sad when school was through.
When they threw me out, I felt so blue.
I was voted the boy most likely to.
Most likely to what?
I don't know, the class broke up early.
How we missed those old childhood days.
I broke my yo-yo.
While Frank, Jerry, and I play hooky for a little while, let's turn the classroom over to Professor Wallington.
Well, thank you, Dean. And now here's something of interest to everybody.
For breathless moments, for your breathless moments,
chew Dentine, the gum with breathtaking flavor.
Dentine tastes so good.
Dentine freshens your breath.
Dentine helps keep your teeth sparkling clean and white.
Dentine, the gum with breathtaking flavor.
Before you go out and always after eating, drinking, smoking, refresh your breath with Dentine. You'll love Dentine chewing gum, for Dentine has a wonderful, tingling, nippy flavor that lingers on and on. It's delicious. And remember, Dentine helps keep your teeth white, too. Keep Dentine handy. You'll enjoy refreshing your breath when you chew Dentine. So for breathless moments, for your breathless moments,
chew Dentine, the gum with breathtaking flavor.
Well, I was flipping through the pages of Variety the other day, and I found a little number that the disc jockeys around the country say is number one on the request list, and they're the boys who should know. So, with your kind permission, here's the little white cloud that cried.
I went strolling down by the river, feeling very sad inside. When all at once I saw in the sky the little white cloud that cried. He told me he was very lonesome. No one cared if he lived or died. And said sometimes the thunder and lightning would make all the little clouds high. He said, have faith in all kinds of weather, for the sun will always shine. Do your best and always remember the dark clouds pass with time. He asked me if I'd tell all the world just how hard all little clouds try. That's why I think I'll always remember the little white cloud that cried. He said, have faith in all kinds of weather, for the sun will always shine. Do your best and always remember the dark clouds pass with time. He asked me if I'd tell all the world just how hard all little clouds try. That's why I think I'll always remember the little white cloud that sails right down and cries.
Well, thank you. Thank you, folks. Well, as we draw the curtain on the first 30 minutes of our show tonight, Jerry and I want to remind you that we'll all be back, including our guest Frank Sinatra, in about a minute. So please stick around and join us, won't you? In the meantime,
we'd like to thank Look Magazine for the wonderful story and cover in the current issue, now on the newsstands.
See you in about 60 seconds. So long.
Hollywood, you have just heard transcribed the first 30 minutes of the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show, brought to you by Chesterfield. Sound off for Chesterfield. Get something new, something no other cigarette has. Chesterfield's mildness plus no unpleasant aftertaste. By Anacin for fast relief from pain of headache, neuritis, and neuralgia. By Dentine, the gum with the breathtaking flavor. And by Bemis Pepsin, the gum that's great to chew and good for your digestion, too. And remember this, ladies and gentlemen. Stay right with us, because in just 30 seconds from now, Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis will be back again.
Tonight, hear Seat of Violence, presented by Short Story on NBC. Transcribed.
Ladies and gentlemen, this special edition to the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show is brought to you by your local Buick dealer. To celebrate the nationwide premiere of the new 1952 Buick tomorrow, January 19th. And now here again is your master of ceremonies, Dean Martin.
Well, folks, I don't know of a better way to start off this special 15 minutes than having you meet our next guest. Some weeks ago, we had a young lady in our show, and we sang a tune that must have caught the fancy of a lot of people. Here is the lovely and talented Miss Carol Richards to join in a second helping of that old soft shoe.
Give me the old soft shoe. I said the old soft shoe. A one, a two, a doodle doodle doodle. Play me that old soft shoe and nothing else will do. That's the dance my darling used to do. We sang love's refrain
just like a vaudeville team.
Dance a whole night
long. We had the cutest routine.
Strolling love is lame.
Weren't my bonnet to scream.
We'd harmonize and doodly-doodly-doo. Give me that old soft shoe. I said that old soft shoe. A one, a two, a doodly-doodly-doo. Give me that old soft shoe and nothing else will do. That's the dance my darling used to do.
Yeah, take a look at that crowd. Look at the people we got.
Isn't that wonderful? We're really packing them in. Hey, look at that old fella in the first row. I wonder what's the matter with him.
Why?
Well, he's been here for 8 shows.
Well, I'm wearing his shoes.
Oh.
We sang love's refrain.
Dean, you were the king of them all.
Dance the whole night through.
And I was the belle of the ball.
Strolling lovers lane.
Weren't my dress the scream?
We'd harmonize and doodly-doodly-doo. Give me that old soft shoe. I said that old soft shoe.
A one,
a two, a doodly-doodly-doo.
Play me that old soft shoe and nothing else will do. It reminds me of the only love I ever knew.
That old,
not the new,
and not the hard,
but the soft shoe.
Soft shoe.
Thank you, Carol. It was very, very sweet.
Hey, Dean, come here. I got a secret to tell you.
I'm sorry, Jerry. You'll have to speak up. I can't hear what you're saying.
Okay. I said I have a secret to tell you. Did you hear me that time?
I'm afraid so. What's your secret?
Well, Dean, you know, the new 1952 Buicks aren't unveiled till tomorrow. And, Dean, I just peeked behind a curtain at one of the new 1952 Buicks.
Oh, dear. Folks, I can't really say I blame Jerry for being unable to resist an advance peek at the new 1952 Buicks. New Buicks are always exciting news. And in times like these, when people are saying the 1952 cars will be pretty much like last year's, these new Buicks are doubly surprising. For the new 52 Buicks bring you advanced new features. Dynamic new power. Sensational new economy. Brilliant new styling inside as well as out. So don't miss the big showing. Be among the first to see the exciting new Buicks at your Buick dealers tomorrow.
Hey, Dean!
Aw, Jerry. Why must you come out screaming like this? Why must you be so bellicose?
Here now, I'm afraid I'll have to ask you to watch for language.
Jerry, bellicose only means audible.
Don't kid me, Jasper. An audible is a thing with 4 wheels and a woman smash them into other audibles.
No, that's automobile.
Don't confuse me, Clarence. Automobile's a town in Alabama.
Jerry, that's mobile.
Oh, no. Mobile is the oil you put in audibles.
No, that's mobile oil.
Oh, stop it, Dean. Mobile oil is from the song of the opera. Lord, don't name mobile oil. Lord, don't...
Jerry, I'm not coming back.
No, Dean. Don't leave me. Don't forsake this poor, sick child.
It's no use, Jer. I'm adamant.
Yeah, how's Eve? Dean, will you do me one favor before you go?
What's that?
Stay.
Oh, all right. Jerry, I have no more time to argue. I'm expecting a very important guest, the famous marriage expert.
Gosh, Dean, I forgot to tell you, he can't make it tonight.
So what are we going to do?
Why not let... Why not let me take the part of the famous marriage expert?
Well, what do you know about marriage?
What do I know about marriage? One of my closest friends is married.
Who? Who?
My wife.
Oh. Well, all right, ladies and gentlemen, we are proud to have with us one of the world's greatest experts on domestic life. He is responsible for more happy marriages than any other living man. Direct from the Viennese Institution of Matrimony, I am proud to introduce Dr. Conrad von Krutz. Dr. von Krutz, I understand you know everything about the state of wedded bliss.
Yes, yes, indeed. When it comes to wedded bliss, I'm a regular blister.
Tell me, doctor, what do you think of divorce?
Well, with a good jockey, I put a dollar on his nose.
I said divorce, not horse.
Horse, that's where you get in the throat.
Look, we did this before.
Yeah, but laughs we got. Let's not fight it.
Doctor, I know you saved many marriages from breaking up. Could you tell us about any special case?
Well, one time a couple comes to me, he hates she hates he. They talk to me and all of a sudden they are having a fight in my office. Before I know it, they are beating me and kicking me and scratching me.
Wow, what a horrible experience.
It's just in a day's voice to me. I stayed cool like a cucumber. I looked up as they were beating me and stopped them with one word.
What was that?
Help.
What was the most unusual match you ever made?
Well, once I made a match that burned for 16 days.
No.
It was 1 inch long and on the head was 6 pounds of sulfur.
No. Understand. I was referring to an unusual love affair.
For 16 days, this match went steady with a candle. This is a usual affair.
Dr. Von Krutz, what do you think of family life today?
Families are too small today. Years ago, everybody had at least 12 kids. I had 18 brothers and sisters.
19 children? Oh, that's marvelous. Are they all well?
Oh, they're fine, but mother don't feel so good.
Well, that's too bad.
Well, you never know where those measles will strike next.
Oh, get out of here.
Oh, no, you get out.
How about a few holes of golf tomorrow morning, huh?
Sorry, Jerry, but I can't. You see, tomorrow morning I've got an important day.
What's that, Dean?
Well, after what you told me, I've decided to take my whole family to see the new 1952 Buicks.
Okay, I'll go with you. They're wonderful. They're beautiful. I saw that.
I know, but they're beautiful. I got it.
Now, there's a good idea for all of you folks. For remember, tomorrow morning, the all-star lineup of new 1952 Buicks goes on display at your Buick dealers. And believe you me, they're the smartest, smoothest-riding Buicks you've ever seen, with new surprise features you thought years away. So don't miss the fun. Bring the whole family to see the advanced new Roadmasters, the exciting new Supers, and the brilliant new specials that combine big car luxury with economy price. Yes, don't miss the new 1952 Buicks at your Buick dealers tomorrow.
Well, I've had to learn many songs over the years, and most of them are forgotten soon after the last note fades. But the great ones stick in your memory, such is the case with this old favorite.
The song that you sang so sweetly, you called it our love's refrain. It's gone and I'm left completely out in the cold again. I dreamed that our love would linger, but just memories remain. As I gaze at that ringless finger out in the cold again. True, it hurts my pride to step aside for somebody new, but down inside. My whole world depended on you. I wanted your arms around me to shelter me from the rain. But now I'm back where you found me, out in the cold again.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much.
Yeah, that was a real wonderful job, Dino. I really enjoyed it.
Thanks, Frank. It's always a kick to get a praise from another singer.
Hey, Dean. Hey, Dean! The horrible thing happened.
Well, what happened?
I can't find Frank Sinatra. He's disappeared.
Jerry, Frank Sinatra is standing right here beside me.
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure.
Good heavens, and I lost my fountain pen.
Dino, before we call it a night, how about knocking off one quick chorus together?
That sounds good to me.
What am I supposed to do while you're singing?
Why don't you run out and get a tattoo?
Listen here, Dean Martin. He's just here once, but I'm here all the time. If he sings with you, I'm going to too.
Well, let's face it, Frankie. We got a trio. Let's do a round.
After you, my good man.
Crazy. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream.
Merrily, row, row, merrily, row merrily, your boat merrily, gently down the stream.
Merrily, 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 merrily,
merrily, your boat gently down the stream.
Hey.
Merrily, merrily, merrily.
Was I rushing?
You better save this for another day, Frankie.
Well, good night, boys. You've both been bricks through the whole ugly mess. Good night.
Good night, Frankie. Before we say good night, I want to tell everybody that we just heard from Marion Marshall, who's in Chicago, and she says that everybody is coming through wonderfully for the March of Dimes. Don't forget, folks, the March of Dimes needs your contribution to help the many infantile paralysis sufferers throughout the country. Please give all you can spare.
So until next week, this is Dean Martin.
And Jerry Lewis reminding you that we appear on radio through the courtesy of Hal Wallace Productions, producers of our new picture, Sailor Beware. Good night.
Good night, everybody.
See you.
You have just heard transcribed the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show, written by Ed Simmons and Norman Lear, produced and directed by Dick Pack, with music under the direction of Dick Stabile. This special portion of the Martin and Lewis Show has been brought to you by your local Buick dealer, who invites you to a premiere showing of the new 1952 Buicks starting tomorrow morning. Remember, you'll have your first chance to see the new Buicks tomorrow at your local Buick dealer.